remain a little longer in Sevilla, but our time is limited, so we continue northward to the quaint old town of Toledo, or Toledo, as it is pronounced by the Spaniards. Toledo is said to be the oldest town in Europe. Here too, as in Malaga, the Romans, Visigoths, Arabs, and Spaniards have carved their history. Even the Jews fled here from Jerusalem when the holy city was sacked. It was also the royal residence of the kings of Castile and the center of the Spanish church. The old Toledo Gate, the main entrance to the city, is a grim and silent reminder of the glorious and inglorious processions that passed through it in centuries long gone by. The only procession now is a modern motor car, checked in its speed by the proverbial milkman and the eternal burro. But in the quaint little streets, there is yet some semblance of romance. Don Jose and Carmen still woo each other, and the strum of unseen guitars goes on. For centuries, Toledo has been famous for its steel blades and typical jewelry, still manufactured by hand in little shops like this. Here we have a sample of Toledo craftsmanship wrought by hand, and a genuine Toledo blade, tempered beyond practical use, but a fine example of the extraordinary flexibility of Toledo steel. This steel is believed to owe its reputation to certain qualities in the waters of the Tagus River, which flows in and around Toledo. In conclusion, we will take one last look at ancient Toledo, once a glorious citadel of 200,000 souls, now reduced to 20,000, verily a mere handful to the tribes who slumber in its hills. But we still hear the song of the brook in the waters of the Tagus, and it sings, "For men may come and men may go, but I go on forever."